Hey.
And hello. We hope you had a great time since we published our last video. Today we want to talk about structures. A structure is a user-defined data type. The data type structure combines several variables with any data type into a logical unit. The variables in the structure are referred to as components. It makes sense to use a structure if you want to use the same group of variables in multiple places. Structures are most useful when used in connection with functions. You have parameters in the function, in and out, where structure types can be used. With the function, you can then easily expand the structure. However, if you change the structure definition, you also have to change all the functions. We think this is important to know, and you should think carefully about if it makes sense to use a structure.
We will give you an example. Ajnan and I have a lot of dates and appointments. We don't want to forget about them, that's why we make a note. We always have to know the same things, date and time. Type of date, is it private or business related, who we are dating, the location and whether we want to be reminded of it. This data structure is always the same. Imagine these data as variables in TwinCAT. All of the variables in a structure can have different data types. In this case it would look like this. Appointment title is a string, date has the type date, time, the data type time. We also have the type of the date, which is a bool. Next the contact, which is a enum, the location, which is a string, and an alarm, which also is a bool. In our PLC project we click on DUT, add, DUT. We select structure. We leave extend unchecked. We will explain this option in a minute. Now we give our structure a name. We call it appointment. Click on open. On top we see type and the name we gave our structure. The structure name is an identifier that is valid in the entire project, allowing you to use it like a standard data type. Between struct and instruct we can do the variable declaration optional with initialization. The definition ends with end type. As we explained before, you can use any data type for the variables except a structure with the same type. This will lead to a compile error because of data recursion. But it is possible to use a pointer, which points at a structure of the same type. We will talk about pointers in an upcoming video. You can declare as many variables as you like, but at least one. It is also possible to declare variables with complex data types in a structure, like, for example, an array. You can also use a structure in a structure, or a function block, an interfaces, and so on. Talking about the declaration, we would like to point out that an 8-byte alignment was introduced with TwinCAT 3. Make sure the alignment is correct if data are exchanged as a complete memory block with other controllers or software components. We will talk about the alignment in our next video, where we also talk about the attributes pack mode and enable dynamic creation. For now we will start with our declaration. We declare them like local variables. First the identifier, the data type, and if needed an optional initialization. We start with the variable AP title, which has the data type string, next AP date with date as data type. Followed by AP time with the data type time. AP type, which is a bool. And for AP contact we prepared an enumeration called contact list members. If you don't know how to create an enum, watch our video about this topic. Next the variable AP location, which is a string. And finally the AP alarm variable, with bool as data type. We are done with our structure declaration and now we want to show you how to access the structure components. Therefore we will open the main program. In the declaration part you can use the structure now like every other data type. We declare a variable with the type appointment. And another one with the type bool and initialize it with true. Now we access the component of the structure with the name of the variable, a dot, and the component name. In the implementation part we write calendar entry, dot, AP alarm, equals alarm on. Now we activate the configuration and log in. It worked. Our alarm is set to true.
You know now how to declare a struct and how to access its component. Now we want to show you some other basics, therefore we prepared another project. In the DUT section you can see that we prepared two structs. One is called a bit boring. In here we declared 8 variables from the type bit. Bit is a Boolean data type which only can be used within structures or function blocks. That's why we thought it would make sense to mention it at this point. It requires 1 bit of memory space. Bit elements, which are declared sequentially, are consolidated to bytes. This allows you to optimize memory usage compared to bool types, which each occupy at least 8 bits. However, bit access takes significantly longer. Therefore, you should only use the data type bit if you want to define the data in a specified format. So, with this example, we want to explain that you can combine individual bits into a logical unit like this and then address the individual bits symbolically via a name. Let's have a look at the next structure. In here we have a component, which is an array, one component with data type bool and one that accesses an enum. We will add another component to this structure. We call it boring and as data type we choose now our bit boring structure. Now we have access to the component of this structure. You can nest multiple structures. To do so you have to declare structure components with an existing structure type. Like we did here. The only restriction is that you may not assign any addresses to the structure components. We will go to the main and declare a variable with the type bobstruct A. If we are online, we see now our nested structure components. Now we show you how to get access to these components. We want to change the value of the last bit of bit boring. To get access, we write baba a dot boring dot and now we select bit 8 and write equal true. Let's log in. It worked.
Next, we will create another structure to show you how you can extend a structure. We name it bobstruct B and check the extend box. Now click on the 3 dots, a new window opens. In here you see the current open project. The folders which are displayed are the folders in which you can find existing structures. We click on DUT and select our bobstruct A structure. In the documentation part you can see which variables are declared in the structure. We click on open and create our structure. In contrast to our bobstruct A structure, in which we declared an extra variable with a structure type, we don't have to do that now. We have access to all variables from the bobstruct B structure. If you look at our new structure, you will notice that after type and the structure name, the word extend and the structure you just selected appeared. We declare some variables now. Next we go back to the main program and declare another variable baba b with bobstruct b as data type. Log in. All components are displayed. We see the components we just created and the ones from our bobstruct K structure. When we just accessed our bit boring structure, we had to use the namespace operator twice to get to the individual components of the structure. With an extended structure, the components are already displayed when the namespace operator is used once. Structures are also often used as data type of arrays. That's why we quickly want to show you how to declare and access them. We declare an array of the data type babastruct B. First, we want to change the value of our color component from green to red. We write the name of our array, in square brackets the index, which we want to change. Now we use the dot again and select the component color. We know that the red is initialized with 1, we write equal 1. We activate the configuration and log in. Start the program. And the color changed. So that's it for today. In this video, we explained the basics of structures.
We will drop another video where we talk about alignment in structures and introduce the attributes pack mode and enable dynamic creation to you. If you don't want to miss this, subscribe to our channel and hit the bell. We also want to invite you to visit our company's website and our LinkedIn profile.
Have a great time.
Bye.
Bye.